Gram-positive coccaea. Plan of the lecture, gram-positive microorganisms, morphological and tincturial properties and cultural properties of gram-positive bacteria and biochemical properties and antigens of gram-positive cocci, toxigenic properties of gram-positive bacteria, epidemiology, pathogenesis and clinical manifestation and laboratory diagnostic methods of sepsis and staphylococcal, streptococcal infections and serological tests used for diagnosis of rheumatism. Taxonomy of Staphylococcus. Gram-positive cocci are classified into two families, Micrococcaceae and Streptococcaceae, and differentiated by catalase test. And the Micrococcaceae are catalase positive, gram-positive cocci arranged in tetrads or clusters, whereas Streptococcaceae are catalase negative gram-positive cocci arranged in pairs or chains. And family Micrococcaceae comprises of four genera: Micrococcus, Micrococcus, Stomatococcus, and Planococcus, and Staphylococcus. And the domain is bacteria, phylum Firmicutes, class Bacilli, order Bacillaceae, family Staphylococcaceae, genus Staphylococcus, species Staphylococcus aureus, and other species: Staphylococcus epidermidis and Staphylococcus saprophyticus and Staphylococcus hemolyticus and etc. Morphology of Staphylococcus aureus. The cell wall of Staphylococcus consists of a thick peptidoglycan layer and a tychoic acid. And Staphylococcus aureus has additional factors in the cell wall, such as protein A and the clamping factor microcapsule. Virulence factors of Staphylococcus: peptidoglycan, tychoic acid, cell surface adhesins, and protein A. Toxins of Staphylococcus aureus: hemolysins, alpha, beta, gamma, sigma, and leukocytine, epidermolytic toxin and enterotoxins, and the toxic shock syndrome toxin. And the next extracellular enzymes: coagulase, heat-stable thermal nuclease, deoxyribonuclease, staphylokinase, and hyaluronidase, lipase, protease. And the cell wall bacteria, the cell wall of Staphylococcus consists of the thick peptidoglycan layer. Yes, and the next is peptidoglycan similar to other gram-positive bacteria. The peptidoglycan layer of Staphylococcus is thicker. It confers rigidity to the cell wall and maintains the shape. It induces inflammatory response and also has endotoxin-like activity. And the tychoic acid, it is made up of ribitol phosphate polymers, and helps in adhesion of cocci to mucosal surface and inhibits opsonization. And cell surface adhesins, clamping factor or bound coagulase, it is a fibrinogen binding adhesin and responsible for slight coagulase reaction. Fibronectin binding adhesins and the collagen binding adhesin, and the protein A has many biological properties such as anti-complementary, hemotactic, and the mitogenic inhibition of opsonization and the induction of platelet damage, and then mediates coagglutination reactions. And the microcapsule, some strains of Staphylococcus aureus have polysaccharide microcapsule which inhibits phagocytosis by neutrophils. The capsular polysaccharides are zeaturonic. They have both negative and positive charges. which is future that is critical for abscess formation. And the next is toxins. Membrane active toxins, hemolysins, Staphylococcus aureus produce four distinct hemolysis, alpha, beta, gamma, and sigma hemolysis. They are membrane damaging toxins, act on red blood cells, leading to hemolysis. They differ from each other by either by their action on RBCs of different animals, their lethal and dermonecrotic and leukocytal activity, and leukocytes and leukocytin. It is also called as pantovalentin toxin. It has two components, F and S. F fast and S is slow, based on their migration on carboxymethyl cellulose column. And the enterotoxin is expressed by nearly 50% of Staphylococcus aureus strains and is responsible for staphylococcal food poisoning. It is a preformed toxin secreted in food before conception, so that it can act rapidly. As a result, the incubation period in short 1 to 6 hours. And site of action, the toxin stimulates the vagus nervus and the vomiting center of the brain. It also appears to stimulate the intestinal peristaltic activity. And symptoms of staphylococcal food poisoning is characterized by nausea, vomiting, occasionally diarrhea, hypotension, and dehydration. However, there is no fever, and symptoms generally resolve within 10 hours. And on this slide, you can see staphylococcus, like grape, stained by gram staining method. They are gram positive. Violet color, gram-positive staphylococcus. Next is culture. Culture characteristics. Specimens are inoculated into various media. First of all, I want to say about sample collection. It depends on the nature of lesion. Direct smear microscopy, yes. Gram staining of pus or wound swab reveals pus cells with gram-positive cocci in clusters. However, direct microscopy is of no value when Staphylococcus aureus is a part of normal flora in the sample. And the specimens are inoculated onto various media and incubated overnight at 37 degrees Celsius aerobically. The colony morphology is observed as follows. Nutrient agar is first. This is nutrient agar. Colonies are 1-3 millimeters in size, and the circular, smooth, convex, opaque, and easily emulsifiable. And the most strains produce golden yellow, non-diffusible pigments, made up of beta carotene, and the pigmentation can be enhanced by prolonged aerobic incubation at 25 degrees Celsius or by incorporation of 1% glycerol or milk in the medium, or if grown in fatty medium. And grown anaerobically, colonies are smaller and grayish in color. And the nutrient agar slope, it produces confluent growth, looks like an oil paint appearance. And the next, second is blood agar. Blood agar, colonies are similar to that on nutrient agar, in addition surrounded by a narrow zone of beta hemolysis, best served in sheep blood agar. And next is mannitol. this is selective media. They are used when staphylococci are expected to be scanty or outnumbered by other bacteria in the sample. And salt is added to the media as it is inhibitory to other bacteria but not to staphylococci. Examples include mannitol salt agar, contains nutrient agar with 7.5% of sodium chloride and phenol red as an indicator. All staphylococci can grow at 7.5% salt, and however, Staphylococcus aureus produces yellow colored colonias due to mannitol fermentation. And the salt milk agar contains nutrient agar 6.5% of sodium chloride and 10% of skimmed milk. And the culture smear microscopy gram staining from the colonies shows gram positive cocci and arranged in clusters. Henning drop reveals non-motile cocci. Next is biochemical identification of Staphylococcus aureus. First is coagulase test, tube coagulase test. it is the most commonly used biochemical reaction for identification of Staphylococcus aureus. Tube coagulase test, it detects free coagulase. Procedure: colony of Staphylococcus aureus is emulsified in 1 milliliter of in 1 milliliter of dilated plasma, and in the test tube and incubated at 37 degrees Celsius, preferably in a water bath for up to 4 hours. Positive test is indicated by formation of a clot that doesn't flow when the test tube is tilted, and any degree of clot fermentation is considered as positive. The negative tubes, no clot formation, should be incubated overnight and re-examined, as some strains may produce a delayed clot. And next is second slide. Coagulase test. It detects a clamping factor, bond coagulase, and procedure: a colony of Staphylococcus aureus is emulsified with a drop of normal saline or on a clean slide to form a milky white suspension. When a drop of undulated plasma is added and mixed properly, and positive result is indicated by formation of coarse clumps, and result should be confirmed by the tube coagulase test. And next is next deoxyribonuclease test. Deoxyribonuclease test on DNA agar, a clear halo is produced surrounding the colonies of Staphylococcus aureus due to its ability to digest DNA. And phosphatase test, this test is positive for Staphylococcus aureus, and Staphylococcus epidermidis and Staphylococcus psilosis. And the organism is inoculated on phenolphthalein and diphosphate containing media, and later the colonies grown are exposed to ammonia vapor. Antimicrobial susceptibility test. Drug resistance in Staphylococcus aureus and production of beta-lactamase enzyme and methicillin-resistant Staphylococcus aureus. As Staphylococcus aureus develops resistance to antibiotics readily, drugs should be prescribed according to the antimicrobial susceptibility test done on Mueller-Hinton agar. And drug resistance in Staphylococcus aureus and resistance to beta-lactam antibiotics. Staphylococcus aureus shows resistance to beta-lactam antibiotics in various ways. First, production of beta-lactamase enzyme. And beta-lactamase or penicillinase enzymes cleave the beta-lactam rings, and thereby organism producing this enzyme develops resistance to beta-lactam antibiotics. This resistance is plasmid-coded, can be transferred between Staphylococcus aureus strains by transduction. It is produced by more than 90% of strains of Staphylococcus aureus. This resistance can be overcome by addition of beta-lactamase inhibitors such as clivalinate acid or sulbactam. And then next is methicillin resistant Staphylococcus aureus. And methicillin resistance in Staphylococcus aureus is mediated by a chromosomally coded gene called MECA and MECA gene, which alters penicillin binding protein and present on Staphylococcus aureus cell membrane to penicillin binding protein 2A. Penicillin binding protein is an essential protein needed for cell wall synthesis of bacteria, and the beta-lactam drugs bind and inhibit this protein, thereby inhibit the cell wall synthesis. And the altered penicillin binding protein 2A of methicillin resistant Staphylococcus aureus strains has less affinity for beta-lactam antibiotics. Hence, methicillin resistant Staphylococcus aureus strains are resistant to all beta-lactam antibiotics. Next is Staphylococcus aureus infections. Staphylococcus aureus is one of the most common causes of various skin and soft tissue infections such as folliculitis, furuncle and carbuncle, impetigo, and hidradenitis suppurativa, and musculoskeletal infections, skeletal muscle infections and abscess, respiratory tract infections, ventilator associated pneumonia in adults, and septic pulmonary emboli, and post-viral pneumonia, and empyema, and sepsis, septic shock, central line associated bloodstream infection. Next is taxonomy of Streptococcus, domain bacteria, phylum Firmicutes, and class Bacilli, order Lactobacillaceae, family Streptococcaceae, and genus Streptococcus, species Streptococcus pyogenes, and Streptococcus pneumoniae. And the family Streptococcaceae are catalyzed negative gram-positive cocci, arranged in pairs or chain. Streptococcus, Enterococcus, and Pneumococcus are the important members of this family. Streptococci are part of normal flora. However, some are important human pathogens such as Streptococcus pyogenes and causing pyogenic infections, and Streptococcus agalacti causing meningitis in newborn, and Streptococcus pneumonia causing pneumonia and meningitis in all age groups. And classification, Streptococci can be classified into obligate anaerobes and aerobic facultative anaerobes group. The latter can be further classified based on the hemolysis produced on 5% sheep blood agar into alpha, beta and gamma hemolytic Streptococci. Streptococcus pyogenes, virulence factors and the pathogenicity of this pathogen. Cell wall of Streptococcus pyogenes is composed of inner thick peptidoglycan layer. It confers cell wall rigidity, induces inflammatory response, and has thrombolytic activity and middle layer of growth-specific C carbohydrate antigen, outer layer of protein and the lipotychoic acid, and M protein is acid and heat-stable but trypsin label, and it is the principal virulence factor of group A streptococcus. And the T protein is trypsin stable, but acid and heat label. And the R protein is expressed by a few strains of group A streptococcus. And some strains of group A streptococcus are capsulated. Cell wall antigens, cell wall of inertic peptidoglycan layer, and Streptococcus pyogenes is the only species under Lanzerfeld group A streptococcus associated with variety of separative infection and can also trigger post-infectious non-separative complications such as acute rheumatic fever and acute glomerulonephritis. And M protein it is the principal virulence factor of group A streptococcus. It inhibits phagocytosis by inhibiting opsonization via alteration complement pathway. It binds to fibrinogen, which together bind to beta 2 integrins and of neutrophils, leading to release of inflammatory mediators that induce vascular leakage and causing streptococcal toxic shock syndrome. And T protein and R protein is expressed by a few strains of group A streptococcus. Both T and R proteins are not associated with pathogenesis. Streptococcus toxins and enzymes. Hemolysins are streptolysin O, streptolysin S, and the streptococcal pyrogenic enterotoxin. Next is enzymes. Enzymes are streptokinase, streptodornase, hyaluronidase, and NADase. And next is serum opacity factor and the S5A peptidase. And toxins. First of all, hemolysins. Beta hemolytic streptococci, such as group A, C, and G, produce two hemolysins, streptolysin O and streptolysin A, S, and they cause RBCs, membrane lysis, that leads to complete beta hemolysis surrounding the colonies. And streptococcal pyrogenic exotoxin, it is so named because it induces fever, pyrogenic, and it is responsible for the pathogenesis of certain streptococcal infections such as scarlet fever, necrotizing fasciitis, and toxic shock syndrome. And it can be typed into three antigenic distinct subtypes, SPE A, B, and C. Streptococcal pyrogenic enterotoxin A, B, C. And streptococcal pyrogenic exotoxin A and C are bacteriophage coated, and whereas streptococcal pyrogenic exotoxin B is chromosomally mediated. And next, enzymes, streptokinase, it activates plasminogen to plasmin, thus breaks down the fibrin barrier around the infected site, thereby facilitating the spread of infection. and streptodornis, it breaks down the DNA, thus helps in liquefying the thick pus containing large amount of DNA and derived from nuclei of necrotic cell and may be responsible for the serous nature of streptococcal exudates. And enzymes, NADase, this is nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide enzyme. It acts on the coenzyme nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide. It is produced by group A, C, and G. It is antigenic and leukotoxic. And C5A peptidase, it is a serine protease that cleaves C5A, which is also a neutrophil chemoattractant, and other include neuraminidase and acetyl glucosaminidase and etc. Their pathogenic role is uncertain. And the culture beta hemolysis and alpha hemolysis and gamma hemolysis. First of all, we need specimen collection and transport. Specimen collection, it depends on the site of lesion. Common specimens are throat swab, pus swab, exudates, and blood. Specimens are transported immediately after collection or in PICUS transport media, composed of blood agar added with crystal violet and sodium azide. And direct smear microscopy, gram staining of pus, or wound swab reveals pus cells with gram-positive cocci in chains. However, direct microscopy is not much useful when Streptococcus pyogenes is a part of normal flora in the sample. And the culture, the specimens are inoculated onto various media and incubated overnight at 37 degrees Celsius aerobically in presence of 5 to 10% of CO2. And the Streptococcus pyogenes is fastidious, doesn't grow on McConkie agar and basal media like nutrient agar or Pepton water broth. It grows only in media enriched with blood, serum, or carbohydrate. Blood agar colonies are small, 1 millimeter, pinpoint, circular, and semi-transparent, low convex with a white zone of beta hemolysis, and stabbing of the colonies may enhance streptolysin O induced hemolysis. Colonies of capsulated strains are mucoid, and liquid media can be used such as glucose or serum broth or brain heart infusion broth. And the selective media used are as follows: crystal violet blood agar and PNF media. And characteristics of these cultures: alpha hemolysis, it is due to partial lysis of red blood cells, producing a small 1-2 millimeter zone of greenish discoloration surrounding the colonies. It is observed with viridans streptococci and pneumococci. And the beta hemolysis, it is due to complete lysis of RBCs. RBCs and zone of lysis is white. It is observed with Streptococcus pyogenes and other beta hemolytic streptococci. And the gamma hemolysis, it is a misnomer. There is no hemolysis surrounding the colonies, hence no change in color. And next is biochemical identification of streptococcus. Catalase negative and bacitracin sensitive. And the first catalase test is this is catalase negative, yes, and on slide this is test on slide streptococci are catalase negative. This is test differentiated them from staphylococci, which are catalase positive. And bacitracin sensitivity testing group A streptococcus is sensitive to bacitracin. And any zone of inhibition around the disc is considered. This is inhibition zone. Inhibition around the disc is considered as positive test, while most of other beta hemolytic streptococci are resistant. Hence, it can be used as a rapid diagnostic test for group A streptococcus. Various tests to group A streptococcus from group B beta hemolytic streptococci are tabulated. Yes. And next is pyrrolidonol beta nafalamide test. This is pyrrolidonol beta nafalamide test is a rapid test which is used in the identification of group A beta hemolytic streptococci and in the differentiation of enterococcus from group D streptococci. Principle of this test, pyrrolidonol beta nafalamide test determines the activity of enzyme L pyrroglutamyl aminopeptidase produced by Streptococcus pyogenes but not by other beta hemolytic streptococci. L pyrrolidonol beta nafalamide serves as a substrate for the detection of L pyrroglutamyl aminopeptidase. The enzyme peptidase hydrolyzes the substrate L-pyrroglutamyl beta-nafalamide to produce beta-nafalamide. Beta-nafalamide is detected in the presence of nitrogen and N-dimethylaminoaminosinamaldehyde reagent by the production of bright red colored product. And the purpose of this test is used to determine if the organism possesses L-pyrroglutamyl aminopeptidase. It is useful in the identification of group A beta hemolytic streptococci, Streptococcus pyogenes especially. It is useful in the differentiation of enterococcus species, enterococcus species are L-pyrrolidonol beta nafalamide positive from group D streptococci, which are L-pyrrolidonol beta nafalamide negative. It is used in the differentiation of Escherichia coli, separating it from other indole positive, lactose positive, gram negative rods. Used to differentiate among the coagulase negative staphylococci. Positive test is bright pink or cherry red color development within 1 minute, and the negative is no color change. Note, a pale pink reaction is considered as negative. development of orange, salmon yellow is interpreted as negative. Streptococcal infections, pharyngitis, erysipelas, scarlet fever, necrotizing fasciitis, and impetigo, and pneumonia, and empyema, streptococcal toxic shock syndrome, rheumatic fever, post-streptococcal glomerulonephritis. Next, pharyngitis, sore throat, pathogenesis. When the organism enters the upper respiratory tract, it attaches itself to the epithelium, lipotychoic acid, which is in the hair-like projections. Next is M protein and the hyaluronic acid in the capsule of the bacteria inhibits phagocytosis, such increasing its virulence. Next process is thus causing inflammation, pharyngitis. And the clinical manifestation of pharyngitis. Clinical manifestation of pharyngitis. This is inflammation process, sore throat. In other words, sore throat is the most common streptococcal disease. Maybe localized tonsillitis or diffuse pharyngitis. Group A streptococcus is the most common cause of pharyngitis in children, 40% of all cases. It is characterized by erysema and swelling of pharyngeal mucosa with purulent exudate formation. And the younger children manifest with a syndrome of fever, malaise, and lymphadenopathy without exudative pharyngitis. Complications occur due to spread of infection from the pharynx to deeper tissues by direct extension, hematogenous or lymphatic roads, which may lead to peritonsillar abscess, sinusitis, otitis media, and meningitis, bacteremia, and post-viral pneumonia. And the next is erysipelas. Pathogenesis of erysipelas. First of all, bacterial inoculation into an area of skin trauma is the initial event in developing erysipelas. Next is the infection rapidly invades and spreads through the lymphatic vessels. And next is this can produce overlying skin striking and regional lymph node swelling and tenderness. And the clinical manifestation of erysipelas, it is a form of cellulitis characterized by a tender, bright red, swelling and indurated pale the orange texture of involved skin due to involvement of the superficial lymphatics along with fever and the chills, and the superficial blebs or bullae may form later. Most common sites are malar area of the face and the lower extremities, and the recurrence are common, occurs after many years, involving the same site. On this slide, you can see patient with erysipelas on the face, damage of cell, bright red swelling and tender cell skin, and indurated pale, the orange texture of involved skin, and the patient hand skin is damaged. Scarlet fever epidemiology. Scarlet fever is anthropognosic disease. The source of infection is a child with scarlet fever or with other forms of streptococcal infection, tonsillitis, nasopharyngitis. And the duration of infection period may fluctuate from some days to several weeks or sometimes months. And the principal route of scarlet fever infection is an air droplet one. Elementary route plays insignificant. The contagious index is about 40%. And pathogenesis of scarlet fever. The principal portal of entry in scarlet fever is a mucous membrane of oropharynx. The infection may penetrate through damaged skin in bumps or injuries or mucous membranes of the genitals, extrabuccal scarlet fever, and the complex pathologic process which may be presented in the form of three lines of pathogenesis: toxic, septic, and allergic ones. And the scarlet fever is mediated due to streptococcal toxins. This is streptococcal protein A, B, C. It's characterized by pharyngitis. It's characterized by pharyngitis with characteristic rash with sandpaper feel, and rashes may be due to direct action of the circulating toxin or as a result of hypersensitivity reaction. And the second, on the second picture, you can see strawberry tongue, enlarged papule on a coated tongue, and a rash in skin folds called pustious lines. And scarlet fever has become less common. Now also strains producing SPE continue to be prevalent in the community. Reasons are not clear. And the next is rheumatic disease. Rheumatic disease affect your joints, tendons and ligaments, bones and muscles. Among them are many types of arthritis. A term used for conditions that affect your joints. Sometimes they are called musculoskeletal disease. Common symptoms include joint pain, loss of motion in the joint or joints, and loss of inflammation, swelling, redness, and worms in a joint or affected area. Acute rheumatic fever occurs in people previously infected with streptococcal sore throat. And the pathogenesis, it is unclear. It may be due to autoimmune theory and the cytotoxicity theory, and the clinical manifestation and laboratory diagnosis. And the first autoimmune theory. Streptococcal antibodies cross-react with the human tissue antigens, for example, heart, brain, and joint. And the cytotoxicity theory, streptococcal toxins and enzymes are directly cytotoxic for human cardiac cells. And clinical manifestations and laboratory diagnosis, it affects heart, joints, skin, and brain. The cardiac lesions include degeneration of heart valves and formation of inflammatory myocardial lesions called as Astcheff noodles. And next is laboratory diagnosis of rheumatism. Laboratory diagnosis of rheumatism. This is anti-citrullinated. Anti-citrullinated peptide antibodies and rheumatic factor. This test measures the level of rheumatic factor, rheumatoid factor, which acts as an antibody against gamma globulins in the blood. And uric acid is a waste product that tends tends to be present in high amounts when a person has gout, which is another form of inflammatory arthritis. Interpreting results, the presence of high levels of uric acid indicates that a person is more likely to have gout than rheumatoid arthritis. And the human leukocyte antigens, tissue typing, this test detects the presence of a genetic marker called human leukocyte antigens B27 in the blood. And interpreting the results, human leukocyte antigens markers in the blood can help a doctor diagnose conditions that have an association with rheumatoid arthritis, such as ankylosizing, spondylitis, and reactive arthritis. And next is rheumatoid factor can be determined by various test methods. For example, enzyme-linked immunosorbent assay. Diagnosis of rheumatoid arthritis should not be based on the determination of the rheumatoid factors. And anti-citralulinated protein peptide antibodies are extremely sensitive markers for rheumatoid arthritis, with very high specificity for the disease. The serological determination of the anti-citralulinated protein and peptide antibodies can support the prognostic evaluation and therapeutic decisions. The use of point of care tests assays in rheumatology and can lead to more rapid diagnosis and thus reduce costs in the care of rheumatoid arthritis patients. Streptococcus pneumoniae, the pneumococcus is a non-motile, non-sporing, gram-positive coccus. In the material taken from the body, it occurs characteristically in pairs of flame-shaped cocci lanceolate diplococci about 1 micrometer in diameter, and the rounded ends of the cocci being adjacent to each other. The cell wall of pneumococcus contains an antigen referred to as C substance that is similar to the carbohydrate antigens contained in the cell wall of beta hemolytic streptococci. And the pneumococcus is capsulated. The capsule encloses each pair, and it is best seen in the material taken directly from the exudates. And the streptococcus pneumonia is a leading cause of lobar pneumonia, otitis media in children, and meningitis in all ages. They are alpha hemolytic and may present as commensals in human upper respiratory tract, and they differ from alpha hemolytic viridans streptococci in many ways, such as their shape, lanceolate shaped diplococci, bile solubility, optochin sensitivity, and the presence of polysaccharide capsule. On this slide, you can see pneumococcus. They are lanceolate shape diplococci. They are capsulated, and culture. First of all, specimen collection. Depending on the site of infection, specimens such as sputum, cerebrospinal fluid, pleural fluid, and other sterile body fluids are collected. Blood culture is useful for invasive infection. Direct smear microscopy and antigen detection. Direct microscopy of smear made from sputum, pus of cerebrospinal fluid show numerous pus cells and lanceolate or flame-shaped gram-positive cocci in pairs surrounded by a clear duodenal capsule. And the direct microscopy is extremely useful, especially for meningitis, as empirical treatment can be started early, and the capsules can be better demonstrated by India ink stain of cerebrospinal fluid. And the detection of capsular antigens in cerebrospinal fluid is more sensitive than microscopy. It is done by latex agglutination test using latex beads coated with anti-capsular antibodies, and we use negative staining method to determine capsule. And the culture Streptococcus pneumonia is fastidious, doesn't grow in basal media like nutrient agar or nutrient broth. Specimens are inoculated in enriched media such as blood agar and chocolate agar, and incubated for 24 hours. This is chocolate agar. This in this slide is blood agar. And chocolate agar and incubated for 24 hours at 37 degrees Celsius in presence of 5-10% of CO2. Blood agar after 18 hours of incubation, colonies on blood agar are small colonies, 1 millimeter, dome-shaped, glistening, surrounded by green discoloration due to alpha hemolysis. And on further incubation, colonies become flat with raised edge and central depression or amburnation due to autolysis of center of the colonies by autolysin enzyme. Colonies appear as concentric rings when viewed from above. Draftsman shaped or carom coin appearance. And next is chocolate agar. Alpha hemolysis characteristics of Streptococcus pneumonia on the chocolate agar plate. It produces greenish discoloration, described as bleaching effect, in liquid media such as glucose broth or brain heart infusion broth. It produces uniform turbidity that readily undergoes autolysis. Streptococcus pneumonia epidemiology. Source of infection is human upper respiratory tract of carriers less often patients, and a carrier rate more than 90% of children of 6 months to 5 years of age harbor Streptococcus pneumonia in the pharynx. Mode of transmission is by inhalation of contaminated droplet nuclei. Infection leads to colonization and carrier state. Disease results only when the host resistance is lowered due to response of associated risk factors. And the streptococcal pneumonia pathogenesis. Streptococcal pneumonia possesses a number of virulence factors such as capsular polysaccharide, C carbohydrate antigen, and pneumolysin, autolysin, pneumococcal surface protein A, immunoglobulin A protease, pneumococcal surface protein C, and adhesins. Clinical manifestation of pneumonia: lobar pneumonia and empyema, and parapneumonic effusion and pyogenic meningitis are the invasive manifestations. And the symptoms: cough, which may produce greenish, yellow, or even bloody mucus, fever, sweating, and shaking, chills, shortness of breath, and rapid shallow breathing, and sharp or stabbing chest pain that gets worse when you breathe deeply or cough, loss of appetite, low energy, and fatigue. And pneumococci colonize the human nasopharynx at an early age from the nasopharynx, and the bacteria spread either via the bloodstream to distant sites, brain, joints, bones, and the peritoneal cavity, or spread locally to cause otitis media or pneumonia. And various manifestations include this lobar pneumonia. The streptococcus pneumonia is the most common cause of alveolar pneumonia, though starts as non-invasive illness due to contagious spread from the nasopharynx. It soon becomes bacteremic and invasive. Patients present with productive purulent cough, fever, and chest pain. Important signs are dullness on percussion due to consolidation, and the crackles on auscultation. And empyema and parapneumonic effusion may occur as a complication of pneumococcal pneumonia. And the pyogenic meningitis, streptococcus pneumonia is the leading cause of meningitis in all ages, except in neonates. And other invasive manifestation, streptococcus pneumonia can cause osteomyelitis, septic arthritis, endocarditis, pericarditis, and primary peritonitis, and brain abscess, and hemolytic uremic syndrome. And the non-invasive manifestations can occur such as otitis media and otitis media and sinusitis, where streptococcus pneumonia is the most common cause. And the laboratory diagnosis, specimen collection, we need sputum, cerebrospinal fluid, pleural fluid, and the direct smear microscopy reveals pus cells and lanceolate-shaped gram-positive cocci in pairs and surrounding by a clear due-to capsule. And the capsular antigen detection in cerebrospinal fluid by latex agglutination culture blood agar, it shows draftsman or carom coin appearance to colonies, and chocolate agar, it produces greenish discoloration. Bleaching effect in liquid media, it shows uniform turbidity, and culture smear reveals lanceolate-shaped gram-positive cocci in pairs, and the biochemical identification bile soluble and optochin sensitive, inulin fermented, and serotyping by Quellenk reaction or latex agglutination test, and mouse pathogenicity, molecular methods such as multiplex polymerase chain reaction, and non-specific findings, high acute phase reactant proteins, C-reactive protein, prolactitanin, and antimicrobial susceptibility testing. And next is optochin sensitivity. Optochin sensitivity on this slide, you can see this is pneumococci are sensitive to optochin disc. This is optochin disc and produce white zone of inhibition. White zone of inhibition, 14 millimeter or more. And viridans streptococci are resistant to optochin.